Thank you, Sushmita ji, for your very kind introduction earlier. Honorable Minister of Steel, Chaudhary Birendra Singh ji, Honorable Minister of State for Steel, Sri Vishnu Dev Sai, Secretary of Steel, Dr. Aruna Sharma ji, Mr. Jhunjhunwala, Mr. Parthasen Gupta, Amit Kumar, we have a lot of stalwarts in the audience, Mr. Mathur, who has all his life provided the raw material to the industry, Mr. Bhaskar Chatterjee, Secretary General of Indian Steel Association, Mr. V.R. Sharma, Mr. Aluwalia, Mr. Ansari, and many other experts here, ladies and gentlemen. It's really a pleasure to be here today, and these kind of conferences give us an opportunity to interact with each other, to know what is the state of affairs, speak out about issues openly. So I really commend the efforts of KTM and the entire team at KTM for organizing this. Let's give them a big hand. Since the theme of this conference is raw materials availability for steel and power sector, so really, I'll just focus on that because we have very ambitious goals. Our Honorable Minister, Government of India has very ambitious goals. So how do we take our steel capacity from presently 126 million tons to 300 million tons by 2030? How do we increase our per capita steel consumption? And why increase per capita steel consumption? Because it directly correlates with quality of life, with the standard of living. So today it's around 60-63 kgs per person per annum. How do we take it to a level of say 200 kgs or 150 kgs? Or maybe it will reduce if there are lots and lots of electric cars by 2030 and they don't use as much steel. So maybe things would reduce. But anyway, the point is that we ought to be making much more steel, ought to be consuming. Our people should be able to consume a lot more steel and have a much better standard of living. And for that, we really appreciate the efforts of the Government of India and the Steel Ministry under the dynamic leadership of Chaudhary Birendra Singh and all the guidance and all the inspiration provided by Dr. Aruna Sharma. We have been working in steel industry, I mean, all our lives, and Dr. Kashyap will agree with me that we can see a new energy in steel ministry. Every time we go with ideas, with suggestions, Steel Ministry is always very, very welcoming, they're very helpful. And the kind of support that has been provided to Indian steel industry from the unfair imports that were happening, that was really critical. Because if Government of India had not taken steps to stop unfair exports from certain countries, that would have completely damaged our industry. Completely damaged not only steel, but everything related downstream also and upstream also to steel. So we really appreciate the efforts of Government of India and Steel Ministry in providing timely support to steel industry. And let's give them a big hand for that. So today the main challenges of steel industry and power industry is really raw materials. Nobody says this. Every day we see the newspapers full of NPAs. You know, 2 lakh crores, 3 lakh crores, 5 lakh crores of NPAs. But I would say most, if you would go deeper into those companies, whether they are steel or power, and you would go and see what are the reasons for these companies turning NPA. The single biggest factor, there would be many factors, but the single biggest factor would be raw material availability. The only reason that we can hope to be number two, we already number three, maybe number two now, number two steel maker in the country, nearing number two. I'm sure man, by March, within 6 months, we will be number two steel producer in the world. But still we are way behind China. We are still way behind the per capita consumption. World per capita consumption is more than 200 kg and we are only 63. So we all have to find solutions to that. But the biggest factor which is in our favor of making steel in India is raw materials, that we have iron ore available. We have plenty of iron ore that is available for us. We have the fifth largest reserves of non-coking coal in the country. But reserves we have, but when time comes for extraction of these reserves, I don't think we are doing a good job at that. We really need to improve. I'm sure there are lots of friends from Coal India here. Coal India has such a great opportunity that it is a seller's market. You know, they say that they can, whatever they take out, they're able to easily sell it. Wherever, whichever regions, if the demand is 1 million ton and they take out an auction only 300,000 or 400,000 tons, and people are falling over each other to pay premium. You know, the companies that are NPAs, they're not able to pay interest to bank, but to run the plant, they have to pay huge premiums to pay for coal, to get coal. So I don't think this is a healthy situation for the industry. This makes us uncompetitive, because we are competing with the world today. And when we talk about and compare Indian coal and its prices to imported coal, it's not really fair. Because when a person in South Africa or in Australia or in Indonesia, when they set up plants there and they are looking for coal, they get the coal at half the price of what we get coal here. Because even in South Africa, they have to transport the coal to the port, then from port to India, from port in India to the plant. So all these logistics, they cost a lot. So ma'am, I would really urge you, and we have Honorable Minister also, and everyone from the Steel Ministry here, we would really urge you to urge Coal India to really ramp up their production. And in ramping up their production, obviously they would stand to benefit a lot too, because they are the ones who are making money on this. Many of their customers are losing money, but Coal India is making money, and we are very happy for that. So they really need to increase their production to the levels that they have promised. And then with this available, if the coal is made available, I'm sure the industry also, power also, we have all witnessed in the last 1 week that power prices are really jumping up. Power prices jumping up just because there is not enough coal. The biggest reason is shortage of coal. The plants are idling. Such huge investments of lakhs of crore is idling just because of non-availability of coal. So ma'am, I know your offices have always been supportive of this, and I'm sure they have their own challenges. Coal India has its own challenges. But with the kind of initiative this government is taking for produce in India, for making in India, so the basic necessity of making in India is that raw materials have to be made available. And I'm sure all those things will happen, and with that happening, I'm sure we will achieve our goal of making steel more affordable, making steel more economical. And to come back to your point, Sushmitaji, you said about using new technologies. So I will not advise, from my experience, or for people to go into new technologies, because we spent 20,000 crores. Okay, I'm the type, I'm going to speak from the heart, I won't speak the truth. All the steel in India was being made mostly from blast furnaces, which import coking coal. I had this thing in my mind, सर मैं हमेशा ये सोचता था कि मैं एक ऐसा तरीका बनाऊंगा स्टील को कि हम जो अपने स्वदेशी रॉ मटेरियल से हम भारत के अंदर हम स्टील बनाए जिसके लिए हमको कुछ भी हमको इंपोर्ट ना करना पड़े और उसके लिए हमने दुनिया में पहली बार हमने कहा कि मैडम आपने नेचुरल गैस की बात की हमने कहा नेचुरल गैस हमारे देश में नहीं है लेकिन हमारे देश में बहुत सा कोयला है तो किस तरह से इस कोयले से हम नेचुरल गैस का अल्टरनेटिव बनाएं यानी कि सिंथेसिस गैस बनाएं और उस गैस से फिर हम 2 मिलियन टन का एक DRI मॉड्यूल बना करके और गरम गरम DRI जो है हम इलेक्ट्रिक आर्क फर्नेस में डाल करके और स्टील बना दें उसमें कुछ भी 1% भी हम कुछ भी इंपोर्ट ना करें हमने ये किया इसके अंदर 10 साल लग गए इसको प्लांट को लगाने में 20,000 करोड़ हमने इसके अंदर लगा दिए और जिस माइंस के भरोसे में लगाया था जो माइंस हमें 2003 में मिली और जो उस जिसको हमने डेवलप किया 20,000 करोड़ लगाए वो माइन जो है वो सुप्रीम कोर्ट के ऑर्डर से कैंसिल हो गई कैंसिल हो गई, कोयले के दाम जो हम सोचा था उसके 4 गुना हो गए और वो हमारा प्रोजेक्ट जो है हमारा वो खतरे में पड़ गया। अब हम सोच रहे हैं उसको कि किस तरह से उसको दोबारा से कामयाब किया जाए। तो जब आप बोलते हैं कि नई टेक्नोलॉजी, तो इसलिए मैं लोगों को मैं सचेत करना चाहता हूँ कि नई टेक्नोलॉजी करने के, नए काम करने की जो है कई बार उसकी कीमत भी अदा करनी पड़ती है और वो खतरे से खाली नहीं होता। तो इसलिए जो है अब हमने जो पुरानी, सबसे पुरानी जो टेक्नोलॉजी थी लेकिन अच्छी टेक्नोलॉजी है, इसलिए हमने भारत के अंदर भारत की सबसे बड़ी और सबसे आधुनिक ब्लास्ट फर्नेस अभी हमने अंगुल में हमने चालू की है, और जिससे कि हम आशा करते हैं कि हम फिर भी हम बहुत एफिशिएंटली इसको बना पाएंगे। और कोल गैसिफिकेशन के लिए भी हमने जो है, मिस बच्चन मैं नहीं से बात कर रहा हूँ ना, इसलिए हम कोल गैसिफिकेशन के लिए भी हम अभी प्रयास कर रहे हैं कि किस तरह से हम कोल गैसिफिकेशन के अंदर हम उसके अंदर क्या कन्वर्जन करें, उसमें ऐसे फ्यूल्स ला करके, यानी कि जैसे पेट कोक है जो हम इम्पोर्ट करके, या इम्पोर्ट करके कोयले को, क्योंकि यहाँ पर उपलब्धता कोयले की नहीं है, हालांकि हम आशा करते हैं कि आने वाले टाइम में कोयले की उपलब्धता बढ़ेगी, अगर बढ़ेगी तो फिर चलेगा, नहीं तो कोयले को इम्पोर्ट करके भी उसको गैसिफिकेशन करके और उसको प्रॉफिटेबली चला सकें। हमें उससे अभी भी पूरी उम्मीद है कि वो टेक्नोलॉजी बहुत अच्छी है और उससे जो है हम कम कॉस्ट के ऊपर हम स्टील बना पाएंगे, लेकिन देर आर चैलेंजेस, बट वी डोंट इजीली गिव अप, बिकॉज पीपल हु मेक स्टील, वी मेक स्टील ऑल्सो मैडम एंड वी मेक पावर ऑल्सो। स्टील बनाने के लिए 100 काम करने पड़ते हैं, तो पावर बनाने के लिए 10 काम करने पड़ते हैं। तो स्टील बनाना जो है पावर बनाने से कम 10 गुना जो है अधिक डिफिकल्ट है। तो इसलिए जो चैलेंजेस आती हैं स्टील बनाने वालों के रास्ते में, हम उनको जो है बहुत आसानी से हम उनको जो है हैंडल करते रहते हैं, या कम से कम स्टील जब बनाते हैं तो कमाई करें ना करें, पैसा बनाए ना बनाए, लेकिन हमें स्टील बनाने में आनंद बहुत आता है, ये हम सब, मैं समझता हूँ ये सब इस बात को मानेंगे। और जब हमारे को नेतृत्व चौधरी बीरेंद्र सिंह जी का मिल रहा है, मार्गदर्शन हमारी सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर अरुणा शर्मा जी का मिल रहा है, हमें साथ, हमें विष्णुदेव साय जी का और सब साथियों का आपका मिल रहा है, तो मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि हमारा भविष्य, भारत का भविष्य भी उज्जवल है, भारत में स्टील इंडस्ट्री का, स्टील उद्योग का भी भविष्य बहुत उज्जवल है। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।